Hello dear students, how are you? Welcome again in my English class. As many topic of writing section we have completed, and today I am going to start a new topic of writing section. This is email writing. Okay, and in this video I will try to sort out the problems that you always face writing email. So now, first of all, I will tell you what is email. Okay? So email stands for, this will be our topic, email writing. Okay? Email stands for electronic mail. Electronic mail. Okay? Email stands for electronic mail. And it's defined as exchanging of messages over communications network. Okay, you know, electronic mail means the messages on electronic mail, it is defined as exchanging of messages over communication network. Okay, and like communication network means mobile and computer. Okay, where you can see and where you can send email, you can see and you can get or send email on mobile, computer or laptop. Okay, so you know, many things can be in email. Email contains text, image, okay, and many things. So what about the email writing? Email means electronic mail, and you can send or receive email on computer, on mobile, laptop. You can use these things, these electronic these communication networks to send or receive emails. What you can use? Computer, mobile and laptop. Okay, so as a defined as exchanging of messages over communication network, like these things. Okay, and it can be many things. It can have many things. It can contain many things: text, image. Okay, and documents. Okay, and any file. It can contains text, image, documents or any file. Understand? And you know why we write email? Hum kyun likhte email? What is the reason? And what about we write email? So we write email, you know, one thing, these things we use while writing email or while receiving email. Okay, and email can contains text, image, document and file. And after that I will tell you why we use email. Okay, for what about we use email. So we use email for thanking anyone and inviting or personal or social reason. For personal and social reason and seeking or giving information. For thanking anyone. Okay? For inviting anyone. For personal and social reasons and seeking or giving information. Okay? And accepting or accepting and sending. Any request. Okay? And so these are the things for which we can write an email. Okay? So these are the reasons for which we can use email. Okay? So, have you got about everything? What is email? And what things we use in writing email? And what things an email can contain? And the reason of writing email. These are the reasons we can write email for thanking anyone. And inviting anyone and personal and social reason and seeking or giving information or accepting and sending any request. Okay? So after that we will discuss the types of emails. You know there are two types of emails. First, formal and second informal. Okay? Formal email can be sent to any authorities. Principal and newspaper okay it can be sent or received from any type of authorities and companies okay and from the principal from news and to principal to newspaper to companies to authorities and or any type of officers okay and formal email we can send to our friends and family, relatives, okay, formal and informal email. Formal email is always use to give, to seek or give information to authorities, principal, newspapers, companies, any officer, school, and etc. Okay, and social authorities. What type of authorities? Social authorities. Okay, and informal email is always used for friends, family, relatives. Is that clear? Okay, then we will discuss that what things we use while writing emails. Okay, so for that we will discuss about the format of email first, then we will discuss the things that how these things that we are using in writing email and what type of these things should be. Okay, so now before start email, we will know the things that what things we can use while writing emails. Okay, so first we will discuss about the format. While writing email, everything should be on that side, and first you will write from. Okay, it means the email address as of sender, as you are writing email, so you are sender, so you will use your email address here. Okay, and then you will use to, means to whom you are sending email. Is that clear? From, you will write your own email address, and to, you are writing to the person to whom you are writing that email, and then you will write date in expanded form. Okay? And then subject. Here you will write subject. Is that clear? And then leave one line space, and then you will write salutation. As respected sir, okay, or for when you are writing formal, then you will use respected sir, respected ma'am, and while writing informal email, you will use dear friend, dear brother, dear father, dear friend. Such type of salutation you will use. After writing subject, you will leave one line space, and then you will write salutation, and after that you will start the body. Body should be in three paragraphs. Okay? In first paragraph, you will use the short information. Okay? You will use the information in short. And second, explanation. And in third paragraph, you will use the solution and conclusion. What the things you are sharing through this email. So these three paragraphs you will use while writing the body, while formatting the body of email. Then you will, in the end, you will write regards and signature. Okay? Regards and signature. Understood? Signature of sender. Sender name. Signature should be sender name. So this is the format of writing email. What things you will use? Here I will discuss, I will write my own address as I am writing this email. From means sender. So you are the sender. As you are writing email, so you will write your own email address here. Okay? And two, in this column, you will write the address of receiver. Okay? Receiver means, here you will write the address of sender. Yeah, I will discuss. Sender address and receiver address. Okay, and here you will write the date, on which date you are writing that email. Okay, which date? As you are writing this email today, so you will write today's date. Is that clear? And how you will write the date? Like today is 25th August. So you will write 25th August 2020. Okay? And subject should be very short and clear. Should be short and clear. Okay? It should be about in 4 and 5 words. So these are the things. This is the format of email writing. This is the simple format of email writing. Okay? And the many things we use while writing emails. Okay? Email two types ka hota hai. It means the email that you are sending to one person. Okay? And the email that you are sending to many other persons. So that type of email, you have to write one thing, the address of BBC and other things, but we are not discussing these things here because you have to write the simple format while writing email. You have to use simple format like that. Okay? We are not discussing all these things. And in my previous video, I sent you that I told you about these things. Okay? I made this video on slides so that I told you about these things, that what type of and how we will write that type of email that you are sending to many other person in a group, okay, a large number of people. Understand? So what things you have to clear here? You know about them? How many things you know about while writing email? First, subject, and second, date and body, okay, and signature. What things? First, subject and second salutation and third body. Body text and last signature. Okay, so first subject. Subject means subject should be, as I told you, subject should be very short and clear. Okay, subject should be very short and clear. Like you know, what is the email about? In subject you will write, what is the email about? Email kiske bare mein hai? Okay, as you will write the email about, as a this email, you are writing this email to your friend and give him, you are writing informal email and you are writing this email to your friend to congratulating him on his success. Okay, so what you will write? Congratulations on your success. Is that clear? So subject should be very short and you have to choose very suitable words while writing subject, and these words should be 4 or 5 and last 6. Okay, and then salutation. As I told you, if you are writing this email to any social authorities or any respective or you know, you are writing this email, this email in formal way, so you will use respected sir, respected ma'am. Okay, and if you are writing this email to your friend, then you will write dear friend as a informal way. So you will write dear friend, dear brother, dear sister, and these things you will use. And body should be in 3 paragraphs. Okay, and regards, last lines, these are regards. And if you are writing the email in formal way, then you will write the complete name. Okay, and if you are writing this email in informal way, so you will write only nickname. Is that clear? Okay, then we will discuss about the things. Yeah, first I will tell you, I'm just showing you this email writing on board, the example of this email writing. Are you looking? This is the perfect example of email writing. Okay, where you are looking the address from the address of sender and to the address of receiver, and date and then subject. Okay, are you looking? The subject is very short and clear, and after leaving one line space, you are looking the salutation is written here, and then body is in 3 paragraphs, and regards, and then signature. Okay, so this is the example of email writing. Is that clear? Okay. Then I will tell you some keywords and some phrases that you can use while writing email. Okay, these are some keywords. phrases. For email, that you can use while writing email. So we are dividing it, the topic, and here we, I'm just dividing formal email, and here I'm dividing informal. Okay, so on which topic? Purpose of writing. First, we will if you are writing the purpose, okay, so what type of words you will use? Informal you will use, I am writing with regards to. There are much difference in writing emails. And if you are writing informal emails, so what you will write here? I am writing about. Okay? अगर आप किसी purpose के लिए लिख रहे हैं, you know, purpose आप डाल रहे हैं अपने email में, so first what you will use? I'm writing with regards to informal email mein. Okay, formal email you will use these words, and informal you will use I'm writing about. Is that clear? And the next topic, for giving information. If you are giving any information, so formal email, I am glad to tell you that. What you will write? I am glad to tell you that. Okay, and in informal you will use great news. Okay, and next, email address. On the topic of email address, in this you will use than you for your email, or here you will use thanks for your email. Okay, then for your email, and here you will use thanks for your email. Sorry, thank you for your email, and here you will use thanks for your email. Okay, and in that asking about, if you are asking about any information, if you are asking about any information, then here you will use can you please give me the information about. Okay, and what things you will use here? Can you tell me about okay? So these are the things that you can, these are the keywords and phrases that you can use while writing email. Is that clear? And topics are given here. If you are just discussing about this topic, purpose of writing. Aapne email kyun likha? Kya purpose tha? So formal email mein aap use karenge, I am writing with regards to. Or informal email mein, I am writing about. And for giving information, then you will use in formal email, I am glad to tell you that. And in that informal email, you will write great news. Okay? For email, for sending email, here you will thank you for your email. And here you will use thanks, not thank you. Is that clear? And asking about any information, if you are asking any information. So in formal email you will use can you please give me the information about, and here you will use can you tell me about. Is that clear? And one thing I want to discuss here, you know, there are so many advantages or disadvantages of writing emails. So what are these? What are these? Advantages and disadvantages. So many, there are many advantages or many disadvantages. So first advantage is here, instant form of communication. Okay, instant form of communication. And helps you, the first advantage, and second, and helps you to send or contact large number of people. Okay? At same time. Is that clear? A large group or large number of people you can communicate together. And third, written record. You can have written records of email, of information. And next, it can be used anywhere or anytime. These are the advantages. of email writing, that instant form of communication, and helps you to send and contact large number of people and group at same time and together. Okay, and written records of information. You can contain the written records of information and communication that you have done. And next, can be used anywhere and anytime. Okay, and there are so many disadvantages of many things, disadvantages of everything. So emails also have some disadvantages like that. What type of disadvantages should be there? First, internet access. Okay, internet access is necessary. This is first disadvantage. Without internet, you can't use email. क्या need है? Email भेजने के लिए आपको क्या चाहिए? Internet. Okay? Internet connection. And second, no guarantee that receiver is reading your email or not. Of reading email by receiver. Okay, and third, as you are sending this email, so this can't be back now. Once an email is sent, it cannot be taken back. एक बार जो चला गया वो वापस नहीं हटाया जा सकता. It can't be delete. Okay? And fourth, virus. Virus problem. So these are the disadvantages. First, without internet you cannot send or receive an email. Or the second is no guarantee that receiver is reading your email or not. Okay, sometimes aap dekhte hain ki aapke khud ke emails bahut sare pade rehte hain and आपको पता ही नहीं होता कि ये भेजा है. सो देर इज नो गारंटी. एंड थर्ड, एक बार जो ईमेल चला गया वो कभी भी टेकन बैक और कांट बी डिलीट, उसे हटाया भी नहीं जा सकता और उसे वापस भी नहीं लाया जा सकता. ओके, एंड फोर्थ, वायरस प्रॉब्लम, वायरस डेंजर. ओके, सो दीज आर द डिसएडवांटेजेस ऑफ ईमेल्स, बट many types of advantages also. As everything have, हर चीज़ के दो पहलू होते हैं, अच्छाई और बुराई. So both I have discussed here. Okay, but informal emails की जगह किसने ले ली है? WhatsApp and many other things. And you can send messages through WhatsApp. And so there is no need of informal emails. So you, I show you the example of formal email here. Okay, as you have seen here, the example of formal email. Is that clear? So these are this is everything I have discussed here about email format. advantages, disadvantages, and the things that need to write email or receive email, and why you write email, the reason of writing emails, everything I have discussed here. Okay, so now watch this video and try to write your own email. Okay, thank you.